from Tampa Bay's streaming news leader, sponsored by the Pink Plumber. This is ABC Action News.
I'm Dee O'Reilly. You'll want to keep the umbrella handy again today. Greg D will have your full forecast coming up. But first, though, I do want to get to your ABC Action News headlines. Investigators are hoping to get some closure in finding out who killed two women in Winter Haven. The families of Latoya Owens and Chanel Brown tell us they think there could be more than one person responsible. They say the scene was so extensive and so gruesome. They believe Brown was likely at the wrong place at the wrong time after possibly giving Owens a ride home.
We just pray that justice is served, that God forgive him, you know, but we do want justice to be served because no one deserves that.
Police are calling Antonio Davis a person of interest. He turned himself in for an unrelated case and is not facing any charges for the murders. Records show Davis and Owens knew each other. Lawyers are back in a Tallahassee courtroom today for second day of testimony over Florida's voter restoration law. The ACLU and the NAACP argue the law violates the U.S. Constitution. It requires felons to pay all court costs before they regain their voting rights. One felon who served her sentence says the law isn't fair.
I don't have a say in our military. I don't have a say in my community. I don't have a say, period. So I think it's wrong.
Attorneys for Florida argue the law is constitutional, citing other states with similar measures. They also say requiring felons to pay court costs is what Amendment 4 voters thought they were approving last year. The Tampa Bay Rays' path to the pennant puts them in the spotlight for at least one more day. They'll take on the Houston Astros tonight at 7 at the Trop. More than 32,000 fans attended yesterday's Game 3. They show their support chanting Rays players' names.
Oh, we were jacking them. G-Man Choi got one.
G-Man Choi.
That's our boy. Instead of Let's Go Rays, it turned into G-Man Choi. Let me tell you what. What an epic event. What a great event.
It's the Red Sox.
Although last night's game wasn't technically a sellout, it certainly came close. If you want to go tonight, tickets are selling fast. Greg, you don't think it's going to be a complete washout tonight, right?
No, I don't. I think there'll be some times when you can get out there and probably get in dry, but other times there will be some downpours. So the Storm Shield app, a great thing to download. In Tampa, the best rain chances right around that evening commute heading to the game time, 3 p.m. to 6 p.m., 60 to 70% chance. By later on this evening, as you're leaving the Trop, I think conditions will be dry. Take a look at St. Pete's hour-by-hour forecast. A chance for thunderstorms. Again, not a solid area of rain. Temperatures will be more comfortable in the 80s, and you can stay ahead of those storms, Dia, by downloading the ABC Action News app.
Thanks, Greg. By the way, you can get free pizza tonight for dinner. Blaze Pizza opened its new location in Trinity this morning. Until 9 o'clock tonight, you can get a free 11-inch build-your-own pizza by simply visiting the restaurant on State Road 54 and downloading the Blaze Pizza app. You can get news all day long on your favorite streaming device. Just download the free ABC Action News app on Roku, Amazon Fire TV, Android TV, or Apple TV.
If there's a clog in your sink, or your backed up toilet starts to stink, the Pink Plumber will fix it in a wink. Call 727-222-PINK. We are the plumbers in pink. If your water's leaking, there's no time to think. Google Pink Plumber and click the link, or call 727-222-PINK.